know, the first thing I got to know that I'm going to be the last speaker, I felt really good, but now I'm not at all feeling good because I think I'm not liable to stand here and speak on behalf of my mom because that's just not it. Y'all are like superheroes, man. Like, how do you do that? Seriously. Okay. So, about my mom, she's not an entrepreneur or a very established, let's say an entrepreneur again, because I believe that she's a very well established mother. A little bit about my mother is that she was always this very Sanskari child who always listened to her parents, whatever they would say. So, you know, if she's walking like this and the parents would turn around like this, she would walk like this. So she was always that kind of a child and she was one of the three siblings. Never threw tantrums, would always be like, okay, I'll do this, I'll do that and all that. And she belonged to a very well-settled family, very well-to-do. My grandfather was the MLA in the city and all of that. But a very conservative one with a lot of rigid beliefs that said that women can't actually work because if they worked, it would mean that the man of the house is not very liable enough, very stable enough to support the family on the financial front. Which is why my mother never could pick up a profession or a career. And she always wanted to do this 9-to-5 job or, you know, just start up like a small catering business or something. I know she had much bigger dreams, but I think she wanted to be a little more relevant. So she wanted like a small job, but it never really happened in a young age. In her mid of graduation, she got a rishta, and because she could never choose a profession, she married at the age of 21. So education was not given so much importance in the family again. Girls were looked upon taking care of the family, taking care of the children, taking care of the husband. And it was a pure arranged marriage. Must have, I don't think they even met before the marriage or something like that. And out of the marriage were two completely different personalities. One was my dad, who was very dominant, very highly qualified. And my mom, who was the submissive one and the suppressed one. So the marriage did not turn out to be a good one. It was a failure because my father did not agree to perform his duties as a father and a husband. And I mean, of course, I love him for whatever he was, but he did not really contribute too much to the marriage. And I think my mother really got strong when she had my brother at the age of 22 and me at the age of 29. So I could really see that fighting spirit in her, which I realize now is when she became a mother. Like, you know, she started making choices. She knew what she wanted because of her children, because she wanted to support her children. So again, she did not take up a job. She wanted to, she went for interviews and all of that, but you know, the parents refused, the husband refused. So she never really got a job. She had to take help from somebody. And luckily my extended family, you know, my aunt is here. She has helped me and her husband has helped me a lot through the financial crisis and all of that. And there was always this thing that my mother used to tell me that, you know, hum kisi ka sirf le nahi sakte, hume dena bhi padta hai. Okay, so that is also a self-respect. So make sure that whenever in life, anybody helps you out, make sure you're always of their help. And no matter if you have to go out of your way, do it. So, you know, she would start her day doing all the household chores of her own home. And she would do the same thing at my grandparents' house. Do all the jhadu pocha, the cooking, the laundry. Not just a single house, but both the houses. And my grandparents' house is like a bigger one. So she would do it with full spirit of ownership every single day because she knew that our children needed some support from the extended family. And I wouldn't say that this was some sort of a deal from my in-laws. Sorry, not my in-laws, her in-laws or her parents saying that, you know, if you do this, we will support your children. No, my grandparents and my extended family are very good like that. But my mother, with, you know, very stubborn, she used to help out. So she would go with my nani to business trips and hospital visits and do all the household chores. And she would be very tired at the end of the day. She has never complained of pain. I remember at the age of 45, I think she just got a tumor of uterus, which she never ever complained. I would see her sleeping tirelessly in the night, and I said, Mom, something's wrong. We really need to go and see a doctor. That's when we got to know that she's got a tumor in her uterus. So she's never ever complained of pain. I think for Mom, brother and me, it was always a family between three of us. And the painful thing about Mom was that she could never even utter a word divorce because of the society stigma. So she could never even walk out of the marriage. And like I said, she was not very rebel. She was like a very Sanskari child to the parents. So she never took up that decision. So my brother, me and I were always like a family to each other. My dad used to be there, not be there and all of that. So we started to do good things, and my mom would really work hard because she knew that she had to really work hard for the children, and the children would give her back someday. I think when she was just supposed to be turning 50, and the same month, just a few days before, I lost my brother, who was just 26 years old and who had just started to do well in life. He was in Dubai. He had just received a promotion. He had just received a promotion, started publishing papers, and I think it was all sudden because he was an extremely handsome, very self-conscious, very competitive, very vibrant kind of a personality. I think I feel sad, but I know my mom was broken and devastated and depressed, and probably she wanted to give up, but she didn't because she knew that her daughter needed her. So she kept working hard. She was always there for her parents, and my extended family, again, you know, helped me a lot with all of that. Sooner I completed my graduation, looking forward to my post-graduation, and got a job, and my mom has gotten back to her education. She's doing her diploma in post-graduation in special education because she wants to support children with special needs academically. I think it comes from a feeling that, you know, you felt disabled in spite of knowing that you are able to do so much in life. So she wants to do something for the children of special needs, and I'm actually so proud of her. I don't know what kind of a message do I give it to all of y'all, because I've already seen so much from motherhood. Yes, I'm a little scared to be a mother, but I think it's going to be a very exciting journey, though I'm not married. Yeah. And yeah, again, I think I don't have to be married for this. Yeah, I think hats off to all the ladies who I've got to know from a lot of journey. And I think today it's coming to a realization that I'm not the only one, or my mom is not the only one who's gone through all this. There is so much happening to so many ladies out there, and they're standing up so well for themselves and the family. Like, really, a loud applause to all of you. Thank you so much. Yeah, and I would pick up a bit of everybody. Like they said that, you know, never give up on your life. There's a lot more to do. So today, like, you know, one more thing I did like to add is when I saw this Mahuna thing on the internet, and I told my mom that I think we should give our story to this. And she said, don't do that, you know, like, it's all gone. It's all passed away. We've come a long way. Why are we doing this? I said, it doesn't mean that, you know, you're still dwelling into it. It's just to support each other, and she was pretty convinced about it. So today when I see her, she's like, you know, she knows how to take care of herself. She attends the yoga classes very regularly. I may miss a gym, but she will never do that. She knows how to dress herself up, and you know, that's kind of really motivating for me, because at one point of time, I thought I might not get to see a day like this. So I think we've come a long way, and yes, I think to all the ladies, like, hats off to you all. Thank you.